Hello friends, welcome back to NoaBio. So today we are going to learn Lac Operon. Now this operon is basically seen in Escherichia coli. Now here lactose is lac and operon means set of genes which perform metabolism of lactose. So firstly we'll see how the operon looks, what does the gene look like and what are the parts which consists of this operon. So the operon basically consists of six major portions, beginning with the first, which is cap site. Now cap site is basically catabolite activator protein site where this cap attaches. Then we have the next, which is promoter region where RNA polymerase will bind. Then we have operator region which has some part of promoter overlapped. Then there is lac Z, lac Y and lac A. So this cap site is basically a positive regulatory site which is bound by cap, that is catabolite activator protein. Whenever CAP binds to this site, there are some changes which takes place in the E. coli cell. Then there is operator site, which is a negative regulatory site which has the capacity to take in or to bind the lac repressor. Then there is lac Z, which basically encodes for beta galactosidase. Now this enzyme has the capacity to split lactose into monosaccharide. Then we have lac Y, which encodes permeases which helps the lactose to come inside the cell. Then there is lac A, which encodes transacetylase, which transfers acetyl group from acetyl CoA to beta galactosidase. Now we'll see one by one what will happen if the cell is kept in an environment which contains glucose or lactose or less amount of glucose. What are the conditions and what the cell will face? So beginning with the first, wherein there is no if the cell is kept in an environment where there is no lactose, that is it is kept in a glucose environment. So this is the RNA polymerase which will go and bind to the promoter region, okay? But as we all can see, there is a repressor molecule which is attached to the operator region, which will not allow the further transcription of the lac operon, because this repressor is attached over here because there is glucose available in the environment. So the cell does not require other enzymes like beta galactosidase, permeases, etc. So this was the first point. Next, what will happen if the cell is kept in an environment which contains lactose? So lactose is basically a sugar which is a disaccharide. So as we all can see, the RNA polymerase will bind to the promoter region again, and then some of the lactose which is present in the surrounding will be uptaken by the E. coli cell and it will get converted into allolactose. Now this allolactose will go into the cell and will bind to the repressor region which is present in the operator part. Hence the repressor will come off of the operator region and the transcription can take place. So the further enzymes like beta galactosidase, permease and transacetylase will be produced and more lactose will be uptaken by the cell for its survival. So basically here we can see E. coli is using or creating or making those enzymes which are required at that point. It is not making unnecessary enzymes. So next, if the cell is kept in an environment which is having low glucose level, then what will happen? So Here in the cell, the CAMP will be produced. Now, what is CAMP? CAMP is basically cyclic adenosine monophosphate. This is produced, which attaches to the CAP, that is catabolite activator protein. Now, the CAP site which is present will have the CAP attached to it if and only if the CAMP is attached to CAP. So what we can see, the CAMP comes and binds to the CAP, and the whole CAMP plus CAP will bind to the CAP site. So here, as we can see, there is attachment of these two to the CAP site, and then we can observe that there is high transcription which is observed because the cell is kept in low glucose environment, so it will require some other sugar molecules for it to survive in any harsh conditions. So next, if the cell is high glucose environment, then what will happen? So here CAMP is not produced, okay, which will not allow the CAP to bind, okay, and there the CAP will not further bind to the CAP site, and there will be low or no transcription at all for further genes. So that was all about Lac Operon. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel. Also comment in the comment box if you want any other videos. Also let me know how you like this video. Thank you so much.